Two towering comedians of our time died this weekend with sharply contrasting appeals, the one and only Jerry Lewis and a pioneer black artist, Dick Gregory. First, Jerry Lewis, who, along with movie mate Dean Martin, and then by himself, ruled the Hollywood box office for years in the 50s and 60s with his zany, hypermanic, slapstick brand of humor. Lewis died today at his home in Las Vegas after battling health problems for decades. Jerry Lewis debuted at the age of 5, singing Brother Can You Spare a Dime in his parents' vaudeville act. Together with Martin and later starring by himself, Lewis made more than 60 films. The Martin and Lewis team turned out 16 pictures together, including such hits as The Caddy.
What would you do without me? What would you do, boy? What would you do without me when I'm gone?
I'd sell my car and huck my ring and go right out and hire Babing. That's what I'd do without you. That's what I'd do.
Others together included My Friend Irma, Sailor Beware, Hollywood or Bust, and a dozen more. After they parted ways in 1956, Lewis continued on screen, starring in films that became all-time comedy classics like The Sad Sack, The Geisha Boy, and Don't Give Up the Ship in the late 50s.
44 and a half degrees blood flutter. No, make that 44 and a third. 62 and two-fifths fly flutter.
They were followed in quick order by 1960s Bellboy and the unforgettable The Nutty Professor 3 years later.
The additive was specifically three parts carbon, five parts hydrogen, one part nitrogen, and three parts oxygen.
Which, of course, is?
The nitroglycerin.
The results were?
Negative.
And?
Noisy.
Noisy!
The Bellboy and The Nutty Professor also were some of the films Lewis directed himself. While busy making films, Lewis also found time to host the annual Labor Day Muscular Dystrophy Telethon for more than 40 years, raising more than $1 billion to fight the disease. Even after his star waned in this country, Lewis remained wildly popular in Europe, especially in France, which awarded him the Legion of Honor in 1984. Lewis also battled personal demons. He was addicted to the painkiller Percodan for more than a decade to deal with chronic pain from his comedic pratfalls. In his last film appearance, Lewis played Nicolas Cage's father in The Trust, released last year. Jerry Lewis, Hollywood legend, was 91 years old. And Dick Gregory, who helped break the comedy color barrier and then used laughter to morph into biting and satirical commentary on social and racial issues, died in Washington last night after a short illness. Gregory emerged from poverty in St. Louis in the 1960s to find unconventional, unexpected fame as one of the first black stand-up comics that had crossover appeal with white audiences, paving the way for such other black comic greats as Richard Pryor. One of his big breaks came in 1961 when he found himself on The Tonight Show. Gregory was able to make people, white and black, laugh about sensitive race issues, once saying, quote, "I gave the country a new way out, healthy racial jokes."
I hate to see any baseball player having troubles, because that's a great sport for my people. That is the only sport in the world where a Negro can shake a stick at a white man and won't start no riots.
But comedy wasn't Gregory's only passion. He would go on hunger strikes to protest the Vietnam War, police brutality, Native American rights, and was frequently arrested. Gregory was shot in the leg while trying to defuse the Watts riots in 1965. He can even be heard on Beatle John Lennon's anti-war song, Give Peace a Chance. And Gregory also tried politics, running unsuccessfully for both mayor of Chicago and for president of the United States in 1968. Gregory was still telling jokes on the comedy circuit until weeks before his death. Dick Gregory was 84 years old.